own desire. So, because remember, every person has that right to either run or not run. So, substitution is sort of like a balance between those two needs, right? The need to ensure the freedom of a person to choose, and the need to protect the political party from disadvantage.
Okay, so you believe there is a purpose to the voluntary provision of the substitution rule?
That's right, yes. We believe that there is a good purpose behind it. Of course, again, it is not to say that Congress cannot change it. If Congress has a different opinion, then, well, Congress has plenary powers. They can do whatever they want.
Uh-oh. But James, you also have lawmakers saying that politicians or candidates have made a mockery of this provision. I mean, clearly when this provision was added, I don't think anyone's seen it to be used in such a manner of an intention to actually put a candidate there. And then, you know what, when you want to close to election, close to the deadline, that's when you substitute. It seems to have been used for some form of deceit.
Yeah, I completely agree. It's clear that this system that's allowed by law is being gamed. It's being taken advantage of in ways that perhaps Congress originally did not actually foresee. So whether or not it's right for regulation, I think that's a question that we have to say yes to. We said it is right for regulation. But again, just to emphasize, the law as it stands, I think it had a laudable purpose in the beginning, and perhaps Congress can now see a way to maybe make it more rational in light of current events.
Okay. Now, after what we've seen for the filing of the 2022 elections, you have some senators also saying, why even make a deadline of filing October 1 to 8 when substitution is until November 15? So technically, when you think about it, filing is until November 15. James, do you believe that should be changed and just make really filing October 1 to November 15?
My personal opinion on this is that, again, substitution is a necessary procedure. It is a necessary process that takes into the law, but I think it is ripe for regulation. Perhaps if you want to avoid the seemingly whimsical use of it, then perhaps add some rules to the application of the process. If it's not the process, it's not very wide open. It's just do it in what circumstances you can do it. Maybe future legislation can go in that direction.
Okay. Another question is, you have more and more groups filing petitions before the COMELEC for the disqualification of former Senator Bongbong Marcos. Take us through the process. If more groups come in, how will the COMELEC handle that case?
Well, just like we're handling all other cases. Basically, you first raffle it to a division, and then after that, you serve summons on the respondent. You basically give the respondent the opportunity to file an answer. Once that answer has been filed, the parties will be called together to a pre-conference hearing, and they will be able to ventilate their respective positions. After that, they will be given 3 days to submit their memoranda, after which the case will be deemed submitted for resolution. Now, if there are multiple cases alleging the same complaints or alleging the same facts, there's a possibility that that these complaints might be consolidated. But again, this is not a sure thing. It really depends on the discretion of the common division that's hearing the case. After the division comes to a decision, that decision can then be appealed to the Commission en banc.
Okay.